Vietnam-based automotive company VinFast plans to build an electric vehicle assembly plant in Indonesia with an investment of $1.2 billion. The plant in Indonesia will serve as the regional production base of VinFast for right-hand drive electric vehicles. The plan is that VinFast Indonesia will supply right-hand drive electric vehicles to countries such as Thailand, Singapore, Malaysia, and Australia. Not only that, the plant in Indonesia will also produce batteries and electric scooters. The plant site is planned to be built in Bekasi, with an area of 200 hectares. VinFast is preparing to penetrate the Indonesian EV market this year by introducing several models wholly made in Vietnam. On its website, the company claims to be one of the largest manufacturing plants in ASEAN, with an annual capacity of up to 300,000 cars and 500,000 e-scooters. In Indonesia, the VinFast plant will produce around 50,000 units of vehicles per year. Furthermore, the plant will absorb a workforce of 1,000 to 3,000 people. When starting operations in the Indonesian market, VinFast will later partner with domestic companies for the production process. In addition, the Vietnamese electric car manufacturer also plans to partner with transportation companies and technology service providers to expand electric taxis. Why Indonesia? The Indonesian government is currently encouraging the use of electric vehicles for its people. This is because of the high subsidies for fossil-based fuels and the negative environmental impact of fuel oil. There are reasons why VinFast chose Indonesia as a production base for their electric vehicles. First, big market potential. Indonesia has a large population, so the automotive market has the potential to grow significantly. With increasing awareness of sustainability and environmentally friendly vehicles, electric cars can attract consumer interest in this huge market. Second, Indonesia has vital natural resources for the electric car industry, such as the reserve of nickel used in batteries. Availability of these raw materials can help reduce production costs and strengthen local supply chains. Third, government incentives. The Indonesian government has set a target that by 2025 the production of battery-based electric motor vehicles will reach 400,000 units for four-wheels and 1.76 million two-wheel units. The target is to reduce greenhouse gas emissions by 29% by 2030. To support the target, the Indonesian government has granted a subsidy of US$450 per unit for 200,000 electric motor units by 2023. While the incentives given to electric cars range from US$1,928 to US$4,178, the subsidy is provided on condition that electric vehicles must be produced domestically. Fourth, strategic location. Indonesia's geographical location could be strategically advantageous for reaching markets in the Asia-Pacific region. Proximity to key markets can reduce shipping costs and enhance supply chain efficiency. Fifth, infrastructure development. The Indonesian government has so far invested in infrastructure, such as reliable transportation networks and ports. There are two major ports that are used for the export of Indonesian automotive products, namely in Jakarta and West Java. The two locations are close to a major automobile industry center that is concentrated in the region of Bekasi and its surroundings, thus facilitating the process of delivery of vehicles for export purposes. Can VinFast succeed in Indonesia? The market competition for electric vehicles in Indonesia is getting tighter. Two brands have already entered the Indonesian market: Hyundai and Wuling Motors. Data obtained from the Indonesian Automotive Industry Association, or GAIKINDO, Wuling Motors held an impressive 75% of Indonesia's electronic vehicle market share in 2022, followed by Hyundai with 20%, attributed entirely to the IONIQ 5 model, with Toyota trailing at 1.4%. During the year 2022 to August 2023, the Wuling Air EV has sold 10,477 units, making it the best-selling electric car in Indonesia. The Wuling Air EV is priced between approximately $15,800 and $19,500, while the Hyundai IONIQ 5 ranges from $44,350 to $50,930. In the meantime, VinFast intends to introduce two models, the VF3 and VF5, to Indonesia. The VF5 will compete with the Wuling Air EV. The VinFast VF5 model could be a competitor to the Wuling Air EV. Especially from its appearance, this model is very compact, so it is suitable for urban communities. In terms of price, the VinFast VF5 will likely be sold cheaper than the Wuling Air EV. This could shift the sales of the electric car manufacturer from China. The VinFast VF5 and VF6 electric cars will enter the Indonesian market this year, while the VF5 model will be the first model to be launched in Indonesia, precisely at the Indonesia International Motor Show Automotive Exhibition on February 15, 2024.